Developing new technologies in the pursuit of more efficient or more powerful machines is a challenging process. Aircraft engine makers know this challenge all too well, not only during the development phase, but even months or years after their products enter service. In the case of Pratt & Whitney, the Federal Aviation Administration, or FAA, has issued a new directive for its PW1100G engine, which is one of their Geared Turbofan, or GTF, power plants. The engine is one of the two options for the Airbus A320neo aircraft family. Let's go deep into Pratt & Whitney's current challenges for today's video. According to the FAA, the latest AD supersedes two previous directives. Pratt & Whitney's analysis of a failure of a high-pressure compressor, or HPC, 7th-stage integrally bladed rotor led the company to conclude that a powdered metal anomaly caused the incident in December 2022. This prompted the regulator to issue the most recent directive, since the anomalies were similar to another engine failure. The previous engine failure resulted in the FAA issuing Airworthiness Directive 2022-19-15 in October 2022, which required operators to perform an ultrasonic inspection of the high-pressure turbine's first and second stage discs. Depending on the results of the inspections, operators could have had to replace either of the discs. That directive was followed up by AD number 2023-16-07, issued in August 2023. Following an updated analysis by Pratt & Whitney, the FAA warned that specific high-pressure turbine first and second stage hubs were susceptible to failure much earlier than previously determined. Building on these directives, the latest stated, "The analysis concluded that there is an increased risk of failure for additional powdered metal parts in certain powdered metal production campaigns. This includes the HPC 7th and 8th stage integrally bladed rotors, with the affected parts, quote, susceptible to failure significantly earlier than previously determined." The Airworthiness Directive issued in August 2023, number 2023-16-07, came out following an engine failure that happened on December 24, 2022. According to records by the Aviation Safety Network, or ASN, one Viva Aerobus Airbus A320neo, registered as X-ray Alpha Victor India Oscar, suffered an engine failure during takeoff on that day, prompting the flight crew to abandon their takeoff run. The FAA's latest directive said that the unaddressed condition could result in an uncontained hub failure, release of high-energy debris, damage to the engine, damage to the aircraft, and loss of the airplane. The effective date of the FAA's latest directive is April 11, 2024. However, the regulator was forced to adjust the compliance times for the directive. Initially, it published a notice of proposed rulemaking on December 12, 2023. Pratt & Whitney informed the agency that an error in the notice included significantly later removal timelines for certain high-pressure turbine first and second stage hubs. The FAA detailed that in addition to keeping the required inspections of high-pressure turbine first and second stage hubs and necessary replacements, the new directive will add angled ultrasonic inspection for high-pressure compressor 7th and 8th stage integrally bladed rotors to identify cracks and prompt necessary part replacements. At the same time, the directive will require airlines to conduct accelerated replacements of numerous engine components, including several rotors, hubs, seals, and blade retaining plates. The FAA highlighted that the International Airline Pilots Association urged Pratt & Whitney to come up with measures to minimize the operational impact that the newly added inspections will have on operators. Still, the union supported the proposed directive without change. According to the regulator, the directive applies to 12 different types of PW1100G engines, as well as 6 PW1400G types, affecting engine parts with certain part numbers. The FAA estimated that 430 engines in the US alone will be affected by the directive. Here are the facts and figures. 366 engines will need high-pressure turbine first-stage hub removals, 351 will need replacements of high-pressure turbine second-stage hubs, 408 engines will need new high-pressure compressor 7th-stage integrally bladed rotors, while 368 will need replacements for 8th-stage bladed rotors. Finally, 283 engines will need to have their high-pressure compressor rear hubs removed. The FAA stated that the following engine models are part of Group 1. Per CH Aviation data, there are 772 aircraft with Group 1 engines that are either active, stored, or in maintenance, assigned to 43 different airlines. 7 aircraft do not have any operators assigned to them, which includes 3 former Go First A320neos. 45 airlines have 738 A320neos with Group 2 engines, including 4 that have no operator. The FAA detailed that operators have to perform ultrasonic inspections on Group 1 engines if this was not done before the effective date of the directive, or before accumulating 3,800 cycles since new, or within 100 flight cycles after the effective date of the directive, whichever occurs later. Repetitive inspections are mandated at each high-pressure turbine engine shop visit, or before exceeding 3,800 flight cycles. Group 2 engines have the same ultrasonic inspection compliance times. The only difference is that operators have to perform inspections either before accumulating 2,800 cycles since new, or not exceeding 2,800 flight cycles since the engine was last inspected. The AD also mandates replacement times for various components in both Group 1 and Group 2, with compliance times shown here. In addition to aircraft downtime and resulting lost revenue, there are costs associated with ultrasonic inspections. Inspecting various hubs and rotors for cracks is estimated to take 80 work hours, meaning that per aircraft an inspection would cost $6,800, totaling $2.9 million for US-based operators. There are, of course, costs associated with the replacement of parts as well, with FAA estimates showing that the replacement of hubs, including the cost of labour, could be between $56,850 and $62,850 per aircraft. The FAA estimated that replacing the 7th and 8th stage bladed rotors will cost $82,850 and $93,850 respectively. Finally, fitting a new high-pressure compressor rear hub is the most costly procedure, with the FAA estimating that incurred expenses per aircraft being $132,850. The August 2023 directive was already shown to impact the bottom line for airlines. Indeed, Wizz Air said that it had 33 aircraft on the ground because of the Pratt & Whitney PW1100G inspections. The company expected to reach a peak of 40 aircraft on the ground by the end of its 2024 fiscal year. The budget airline noted that the expected shop visit time needed to return engines back to service was around 300 days. And of course, it's not just Wizz Air feeling the impact in Europe. In fact, Lufthansa Group's latest annual report also expressed concerns about the issue. The carrier stated, "This problem entails the risk of operating interruptions, a shortage of spare parts, and higher maintenance costs for the airlines in the Lufthansa Group that use these engines." Some carriers like Air Astana or Spirit Airlines have finalized agreements with Pratt & Whitney for compensation. Spirit Airlines in particular will receive a monthly credit through the end of 2024, subject to certain conditions. In response to the latest issues, Pratt & Whitney has continued to expand its repair and maintenance facility in recent years, including more capacity for aftermarket repairs for certain components for the GTF engine. What do you think about all of this? Do you think this is as bad as Rolls-Royce's Trent 1000 issues? Share your thoughts by leaving a comment. Simple Flying publishes over 150 articles every week. If you're looking for the latest aviation news and insights, visit simpleflying.com.